How are you?
Good.
Good? How are you?
Good.
Welcome, everyone. Okay, thank you for your, you know, taking your precious time to be with us on a Saturday afternoon. You should be with your parents, your mom, dad, children, your garden, whatever. And thank you so much for being here. And today, the person that's going to lead us to this whole conversation and back and forth question, answering, it's going to be Mike. And the county is here, so you need to pick there. If you have any question, concern, you need to ask the county the questions about your garden, about the future of, you know, this growing cannabis. Okay, and I'm going to say a few more words so that they know what's going on here for some of the elders there. There's one mission, I'm not okay. No share, you know, they charge it,
And without further ado, I'm going to have, can you give me a hand for Mike?
I get a lot of questions from everyone in the community, and a lot of the times I can't answer the questions because I don't work directly planning all the time, and I don't work there, but that's why I had this meeting, is so that if they did have questions, now is the perfect time for them to ask so that we can make sure they're clear on everything.
Okay, and can you also add that we do not want you to answer those questions? These are the people that need to answer those questions.
Planning question. Okay, so we'll start with introductions. If you guys can introduce yourself.
Your title, your responsibility to the county, and so they know who you are and what you do. how scary.
Cody, let's start with
also,
you.
My name's Cody Smith. I'm one of the new code compliance specialists. Basically, what my job is to come out and do the site inspections on your guys' sites, to let you know, based on our ordinance, kind of where you guys are at, what you need to do to move forward, and things like that. I've lived in Trinity County my whole life, and it's very important to me personally that this works, and I like to hear feedback from you guys based on how we're doing things, maybe that we could do better.
I'll translate that. Cody, 你要对你女婆在车了过的地呢? So maybe now I'm going to do a little bit of 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 a little bit
of a little bit of a little
bit of a little bit of a administrative coordinator, so I handle all your emails. I process all your paperwork, residency deeds. So I'm the one who sends you emails, and you talk to me and the admin clerks at the front counter. I recently came to this county in September, and I actually came to live in Hayfork. I really love this whole community, and I would love to see this industry work and flourish and create jobs in industry and economy.
My name is Jeff Dickey. I'm also a code compliance specialist. I'm, I guess, top dog with the code compliance guys. There's three of us. I also do the site visits, work with you on making you understand our ordinance and what we expect of you as growers. Answer any of your questions. Basically, we come to your site, and when we leave, hopefully you understand exactly what it is that we're looking for from you, so that you're following the parameters of our ordinance. I live in Hayfork. I've been here for 22 years. I also want to see you people succeed.
Tonight, Jeff, the Ali Cody Kalashini had to wish I can hold it up anyway. Tua Potena,
My name is Scott Watkins. I'm the new cannabis planner. I'll be helping with conditional use permits and variances. I have been working off and on before I got this job here in Hayfork on a farm. I understand how much hard work goes into it, and just trying to help out where I can.
My name is Scott. I'm the planner. For example,
Ron Hanover. I am a deputy with the Trinity County Sheriff's Office. I've been working with the Sheriff's Office for 21 years. I'm currently the manager of the Marijuana Code Enforcement Program, and I'm the enforcer of the county codes on marijuana regulation.
Ron Hanover, you have to sheriff.
I am Leslie Hubbard, and I'm the interim planning director. I started with this about a year ago, and I want it to succeed. So I have met with Mai and met with Adam to talk about what some of the challenges are for your community, and that's why I'm here today. I've been in Trinity County for about 23 years.
parts of the program. Satunaya Leslie, Ningyang Honglu County, not the Mango Beishong, that's new Beholuna, the Lu County from Beishong. Ningyang Boy Shai Tan Tall, Yanay of Tall, which is there, or your tall permit jaw, anything you have to Shai Tan Tall, you know, you to Kia, Jaholuna, and you have the only staff or go, Loya jaw, program, no, Mukoy, Jongdo Shadot here.
Good afternoon, my name is John Finley. I'm the supervisor for Trinity County's District 5. We're currently in District 3, which is Supervisor Chadwick's district. I want to acknowledge she's here and thank her for coming. We were asked to come here specifically to speak to people that live in Post Mountain, especially if there are problems in Post Mountain, and what you can expect in the future.
Yeah. Here we go. I'm John Fenley, the supervisor for the Hulu District G. Basically, District G is a show dog. Okay. That's not been your whole Bobby Chadwick Blue District, District A. You have to go, that's a show dog, my John Fenley. So, big young, little, a little cat, so, little dog show here, the guy you want to get a pet.
Also want to include, we were invited here. This is your meeting. This is a private meeting. It is not public. We are here to serve you and answer your questions. And if there's something that you don't like going on, you can always tell us to leave and kick us out. Oh, you got that. Okay, great. Leslie has been with us for just a few months, about a year or what? A year or so. She should have been with us probably about 5 years ago. We're late in coming to the table. Ron has been with us for a while. He's only been working code enforcement for a few years. These other staff members with planning should have been here 3 or 4 years ago. I apologize that they weren't, but this is Trinity County, and we have supervisors that don't agree on a lot of things sometimes, unfortunately. As far as I'm concerned personally, our cannabis... shouldn't say this, but our cannabis ordinance is a sorry sight, and we will continue to work on it and make it better, make it more compliant with the state and easier to understand and easier for you to comply with. I'm here specifically regarding Post Mountain Trinity Pines. It is a very difficult area. There's a lot of people that are invested in Trinity Pines and Post Mountain. And it is not a very good place to invest. Honestly, I can tell you my personal feeling, not necessarily professional, is that when the people came to this county looking for a place to grow their plants, they were probably abused and ripped off by certain realtors and not told the truth as to what you can and can't do regarding cannabis. Since then, the state has put its ordinances into place. I've worked to put those ordinances into place because I want regulation for this product. I want it to succeed. It will succeed in this county. It might not be in the vast numbers that everyone expects, but it will succeed and it will be a good place to grow, and it will be an incredible community for you to raise your children, your grandchildren in. That's my goal. You want to go for that?
I'll try.
Okay, sorry about that. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Adam, you try that one. You wrote notes. I didn't write notes. That was the
I don't even know what I said, so.
All right. I'll do my best, John.
Okay, thank you.
New York to into county board supervisor, not New York, John, and New York to Sharp Post Mountain. They monkey what they did on that, they find one. They were New York to long chi, just I lower the permanent ordinance, not my protection, Melissa, work a young yi dog. Here, work a more it's a tight dog to stay in that, they don't the talking name on the new shell board, yeah. Need a natural drunk for that. มันจะเจ็บมายุ่งหินนะนี่จะเอาเตะฝุ่นตรงนั้นที่จะยึดพับเท้าว่าเลยเดียวอยู่มั่วอยู่เติร์กเองนะมุดจอดูอยู่จอดเองจอดรูปเติร์กนะโอเคให้เราไม่ยุ่งเกินนะซึ่ง
All right.
One other thing, I don't know if there's misunderstanding. The county cannot do anything it wants regarding cannabis. We have to comply with what the state of California has set up as the law. We can make some changes to that. We can make it harder or have you grow less plants, but we can't let you grow more. Otherwise, the county will get sued. If Bobby and I and Judy Morris passed an ordinance that allowed you to do whatever you want, the state would stop us. The state would stop you, the state would shut us down.
So, for example, they have a Beidou supervisor, Lee Bobby, Tia, Nutia, Judy, more the dialogue, Ji, Dumbo, the state of China, the Bunyona, gave Lee more than the state.
I talked to May in the past, and I don't know if this is good or not, but I honestly always question how the people are going to survive in Post Mountain, and if they can, because of the way it's made.
And I don't know if anyone's personally approached you with
this,
but I will officially, publicly tell you this. I've always had the idea that the pine should be treated differently, obviously. I don't think it's a good idea to dig 1,000 septics up there. That's obviously not good for the environment to move that much dirt.
Oh, but that is the next step. That would be the proper way for it to move forward.
Yeah.
First you have to build house, build septic,
build
infrastructure. Then you would look at opening up a water treatment plant and everything like that. That's just the way it would be.
So for me to kind of avoid the reckless abandonment, people just leaving and not trying to clean up, and you know, I think the best thing to do is to treat it as a different area.
Okay.
Instead of allowing them to do commercial, you know, 10,000 an acre of cultivation, maybe limit them to cottage and not require all of those stringent things of digging a septic, building a house, but allowing them to grow, at least giving them guidelines to say, here's the field you can play in, treating it as ag land and saying,
overlay would be the most appropriate mechanism to do that. The thing is, I don't really want to get into that, especially regarding Post Mountain today, because I want you to understand and know what your future possibilities are.
But I want to put it on the table.
It's on the table, and Leslie's been thinking about it. My main concern is how do you make ends meet next year, this year?
I have one question, for starters, actually two questions. Is there anybody here that wants to discuss anything other than cultivation?
or is it all cultivation?
So, 我们的段落是它责任和
nursery, testing,
nursery,
manufacturing,
In Post Mountain, the Trinity Pines,
not retail, but actually in
the Pines, you own property there and you are willing to start doing this in the Pines?
Doing what? Micro business?
Micro business, the whole thing.
I think a lot of us own property there.
Do you own property there, or are you representing other people that
I personally own property there, and I represent a lot of people in the Pines.
Okay.
And I think micro business for someone who is going to have a hard time, as you said, making ends meet, which I wouldn't say that. I'd say we'd have a hard time competing on the California level because of how big grows are and stuff like that.
But you still can with a refined, excellent product, correct?
It's an
Is that what you're looking toward doing?
Oh yeah, but what I mean that's an opinion for sure. But what I would say is it would be nice to be able to cut the cost of having to take it to a distributor, of being able to move your own product, package your own product, and that is always having a superior product, but also being able to take it to retail.
And at some point, micro business will come before the planning commission and the board. So
I think that's going to affect
April 26th.
Yeah.
And that would be where you would start discussing it.
The PC on April 26th.
I think a lot of people, if they don't know about it in the room, that's going to be what allows people in Post Mountain to
stay and to produce product.
Yeah, I think so.
That might be a separate conversation completely. So easily, the majority of people want to talk about cultivation.
Yes.
Okay. That's my first question. Second question, do a lot of people here have an issue with residency?
What do you mean by residency?
County, showing that they have Trinity County residency as a prerequisite for their license.
Okay.
I will say, 你一家多呢，我等你再
So I'll just repeat what I just said. A lot of people just haven't been vocal, but definitely that was one of the big issues that we had. Okay. Everybody has been a resident of Trinity. It's just, again, like how we talked about before, too.
Right.
We just got literally an address up in the Pines not too long ago. Everybody's moving forward. But again, like I said, you're talking about like producing receipts. Everybody has receipts. You're talking about actual physical ID that shows, reflects the property that we have up at Trinity. No.
Yeah.
I can vouch for myself that don't. I live in California, I have a California ID, but to have an actual physical ID that states that that is my resident, no, I don't, because again, we just got literally an address not too long ago.
Right, and that's been a big issue for a lot of people in your community. So our ordinance says you need to be a resident of Trinity County, but it gives me, as a planning director, some discretion in being able to determine your residency. So we've gotten pretty creative with taking receipts. A lot of people have been in a seasonal lifestyle here. You've lived here for a few months out of the year, you know, usually between March or April and October-ish, something like that, and then maybe you'll go travel somewhere or live elsewhere. Mm-hmm. Some people have second homes here. If you've been off the grid or could not get a post office box, I'm aware of that. Mm-hmm. So if you have something that you can show, even as seasonal.
Johnny Pumper.
Yeah, we are taking those. Yep, we're taking those also.
Propane,
anything? Wiley's Market. A lot of people keep their Frontier Fuel, you know, their receipts from Frontier Fuel or from the feed store.
Bays. Everybody got Bays. I can tell you that. A whole bag of it.
Bailey loves you, right?
Yeah. Oh, Bailey loves us.
Let everybody know about the receipts in here. Can you translate?
Oh. They are
好的，他的老爷的了，包的背包嘛哈，开了老爷的，这边要是那么差一箱，那是老爷的，我receipt啊，去，都到了啊去，那有啊去，你要给路上的，要receipt那种的嘛，对，叫啊不对，那有啊那，那有我找了有propane了，有我找有毛的的，叫我叫receipt可对，叫的啊，这一块proof的，这里你要是那么啊一箱子，那得到了来噻。
And we've gotten even more creative. Most everybody has a phone. So if you've been taking pictures of your site with your phone over the years, show them to me.
So, yeah,
show me that you've been working on this site for a while.
Yeah, me,
But if they have specific questions,
turn in whole package for the county. The Udai Hall residency. We had the Umaku Yao Oshin resident. The Shimawa the GSF whole package. We had the Ujin Yoko in our Asian residency. The Yana, the Lawyer Haya, you are done to Pana Hana. Had come up to see not just the people who got into email job to receive a big time project as you know, had not thought to talk to director, not shy, shame for Puna. They not really not the Kimachi
enough.
Okay. They are there, you are there, you are there, you are there,
you
are
he is an applicant that turned in his package or application a month ago. He's been here for 2 years, but he doesn't, his ID isn't.
ID, the Shima. The ID, the good for whatever reason, no sticker for energy is true. Tor Guna, the Shima, what's the issue? We didn't bear over in 1 year with the CDR.
So,
portable toilet, everything.
He's just like, he hasn't heard from you. Okay.
Yeah.
And that it might take, hopefully I will get to every application very soon. We're catching up, but there's still a lag period between the time that somebody submits that application and when you hear back about it.
Okay,
we're getting faster, but it still takes a little bit.
They wouldn't accept the application.
Okay. So why don't we talk about each of these cases privately?
So for the residency, I require a California ID. Your address doesn't have to be in Trinity County on that ID because we understand that people fluctuate. I can't accept non-formal residency, only the planning director can.
Okay.
If you don't have an email and I call you, most people don't pick up their calls, they don't have messages. I want an email because that way we both have written correspondence. So if they send something to you, you can translate it. Or if they have issues with language, we can at least clarify.
Yeah.
And we can can set up appointments that way. Yeah. Because I have a small staff of probably 50 people I've called.
How about I help him, because I haven't helped him with his application yet. I can talk to him separately and then try and see what he has, and then we can work together.
But that's all in general. He's got emails, the residency. If there's a residency issue where it's not formal, it goes straight to her. And it's easier just for you guys to make an appointment with her and then bring in an application that we can accept.
Okay. So the way sai ta nung na the reason why did you got sai because what you want a California ID can whether got an ID that you can yang or you don't know chi yang la it's okay to want to get California is it you got you want the you chi got is that you got what the and then you got to mo me in top the okay so you got I don't know here
go 我这是个去特别，你多放点在啊，找个特定地方嘛，你看的，你place have California ID doesn't mean that you live here.
Oh.
You have to prove that you
continue to use some kind of business.
Oh,
so he has his California.
Sure. Why don't we, whoever has those residency issues, let's meet, and I wasn't trying to settle that with everybody, but why don't we meet, because that's been one of the biggest stumbling blocks, so why don't we meet and just get those?
Okay.
Set up a time with you, and maybe you could go over to the same time in the office.
Very important, what Rachel brought up regarding email trails. If you could talk
about yeah, so coding
We're not. I don't understand. Exercise their civic.
They don't have an ID in Trinity County. Can they vote?
I have no idea. You have to talk to elections about that. Yes. That's an elected official, same
we
as a
can
supervisor.
Discuss that later. Okay. Yes.
Okay. All they need is they have a social security number and a physical address. I think that's all
they need. Yeah. But do go to that.
Tell everyone that, from my experience with dealing with the planning department, if you've been here for more than a year, you'll be able to prove it to them. They're not.
We can figure it out.
We'll figure it out. And they're really open to, if it's a case by case, you know, if you can prove to them through, I mean, I know we've even looked at people who had deeds for multiple, or a deed, property they bought, say, 4 years ago, and then other information saying that they've been here to show that they bought the property 4 years ago, they have received. 4 years residency.
So you like to more achieve her residency. I know that don't do too much, but you just wanna lay in okay. Join a name on me or lay in the shy. Show me the detail, the receipt.
There hasn't been one that we haven't been able to figure out.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
This is probably for 10 years, Leslie, and he, what are we going
to? Peng Luo.
Peng Luo. His name is Peng Luo. Financial, Zhong Luo. He's located up in the pine. First, he has a concern, and he paid $15,000 for his consultant to get it done, and he didn't get his temporary license. In addition to that, he paid $6,000 for 2017-18. So nothing gets done. And then 2018-19 here, he already paid $6,000 on top of that. So he is very worried about what's going on here. Is there a value for what I'm paying? Because he shared with his other friends and they think that he's an idiot. Why is he wasting his money away when he didn't get anything done? And they get to grow and doing the same thing.
Have they paid for a permit? And who did he give his money to?
Come on, you know,
for the consultant?
For the consultant.
Later.
And I have no idea who that is, and we would not suggest he give his money to any consultant. That's between him and his consultant. Has he actually written checks or given cash and gotten a receipt to the county? You got it.
Okay, receipt from county 10 years, they got paid 6,000.
Okay, good.
And the second thing is, he feels so embarrassed because his other friends laugh at him for doing this.
Okay.
And they get to do the same thing and not pay a penny. That's the first thing. Secondly, he feels that if there's no value on his 2017 and 18, can he apply the $6,000 to the 18 and 19? And the ones that he just paid, mm-hmm. A couple days ago he paid the 18 and 19, $6,000, can he push that to 19 and 20? And then, if he doesn't get any value, can he get a
refund?
Well, either he can get a refund or he can get some incentive, such as stacking. And he wonders if he can get up to like 20,000 square feet for his farm. So, you can answer him.
You're not going to negotiate with him. Trust me, you are not. So, go ahead and take this one.
Okay, so the 17-18, when you paid for the 2000, we're in our third licensing year. It started in 2016-17, then there was 2017-18, and now we're in 2018 and 19.
So let it be only your license, not the payroll show, or not?
Okay.
But she's not your
payroll.
So you pay? So you pay, or not? You just pay, or not? You just pay, or
not? You just
pay, or not? You just pay, or not? You just pay, or not? You just pay, or not?
I think the real issue here is they want their piece of paper saying that they to the city.
Right.
Okay.
And if they.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Thank you.
And I can jump forward. So if you have paid for your 2017-18 and you paid for your 2018-19, you should be able to go to the state and apply for a temporary cultivation license and be able to do it. And we will say, yes, go ahead. And we can issue a license to you if you are in that category of having paid in 2017 and 2018.
So you could pay some of her last year take a renewal, get a go by the state, $1.
So the value, if his question about the value of 2017, he's wondering what value was that. When the county started the licensing and put 500 licenses out to be available, I don't think anybody knew if they would be sold in the first 2 months or if it would take a long time. Nobody knew. And so the value of 2017-18 was to secure one of those licenses. And even though most people, if you go back and you look at 2017, you weren't really supposed to cultivate until you had your county license and your state license.
Okay, not quite sure how relevant this is to his bottom line, but
it's the number. It's not
just the value of the lot.
So it was to secure the slot, so to speak.
One additional thing, we cannot help with your embarrassment. I understand it though. The other item is, as you come into compliance, pay for your permitting and pay for your state permitting, you will come to me or come to Ron or enforcement and say, my friend doesn't pay. He's not in compliance. Get rid of him. I'm in compliance. I'm growing. I'm making money. I'm doing things the right way. Get the gorilla grower out of here. I know, but it's just, you can drive 100 miles an hour down the freeway and maybe get a ticket, maybe not get a ticket. But it's just the way it is. It's the way it's moving. But if you want to work at it, I want you to succeed.
You have to feel safe.
You have to feel safe and that you have a future to be able to produce cannabis.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
nên có một cái đồng anh chị cái đấy thế nên có thẳng bò á nên có thẳng á nên đồng cái có một cái anh chị gì nhỉ lớn cho nó lớn ba một chế gì nhỉ lớn ba là chỉ là cái nhóm của nó đấy chỉ cần nó lấy một chế chế gì đấy tụ tụ cù lý rồi giờ tụ nhót cần nó cái nó là cái gì lớn cho đủ nó mà tụ bên nông tụ lý mà lớn chỉ sao mà tụ cù lý tết nó đủ tụ bên nông này lớn nó hả So with the conflict of interest and that, who lead in this morning, it's all,
yeah,
no. Tell me more, it's all, isn't
it? No, I'll follow.
They're gonna be he's using a little bit metaphor or kind of like be around the bush, but he wanted it to be like you know right on the spot here and they have a lot of rumors that there's gonna be chaos in the time these 7 years so that $350,000 payment for enforcement. And can you kind of honest on that? should they be worried? Should they tell their friends to be aware that maybe fishing game will be the sheriff will go out there and serve chaos or just go and do the right thing? And,
how does enforcement?
Okay, enforce the right thing. You know?
Let me start with that. First of all, who you're looking at here is civil only, no criminal.
Well.
I'm not talking, I don't care. He says he can go either way. That's his problem. But set him aside, we're only looking at civil. No criminal. Rumors are rumors. That's exactly what they are. We have no control over fish and wildlife. That's their own little mindset, whatever they want to do and what they do. They don't let us know of their plans, at least me. They might let Ron
they
know.
They let me know.
Okay. Of what's going to go on? Who they're going to bust?
No.
Okay. And that's what we're talking about.
Their strategy. I can capture their strategy.
And can you repeat it?
Yes.
Okay. Go, yeah. Then let's hear it.
Okay.
Thank you.
So there's different agencies.
That's speaking all I mean. Just tell them, staging them to understand you first.
Go for it.
ปลอดรู้ว่าเจตนาในเป้าเป้หนอมาตัวก็ว่าตรงกว่าแล้วก็ชมก็ไม่แข็งนี่น้องเราเนาะน้องเราเนี่ยเป้หนอๆที่ตรงเราเลยที่ตรงนะนี่เป้าไปแล้วลูกป้าไปตัวซะมวยคอนเฟสแล้วก็ชูนะเจฟิชชิงเกมเราตัวเจตรงจะตัดล้วนเราเลยเจตรงนั่นแหละนี่น้องเราเนี่ยนะเจตแต่ฉันจะอ้อนน้องเราเป้เนี่ยเลสนี่จะตัวดีเรคเตอร์มันนี่โอ้โหเลยนะฟิชชิงเกมนะ Can you explain a bit that Nepal fishing game do appear na song no do ko cha yin ni ke pe ke ni no go ahead.
Okay, so fishing game has been to my site and has been to Adam's site. And the reason we did that, I asked that fishing game go there to have the conversation with you and to look at an individual site and say, here's how you would deal with making this site better. They are prioritizing areas that are not in the licensing program. The first thing that they do before they go to a site this year, they look at it with aerial photography and they say, it looks like that could be a site that could endanger a certain water course. But then they contact me and they say, is this in your program or is this not in your program? If I say it's in the program and they say, well, you know, you might want to go look at that because it's really close to Hayfork Creek, then we send our compliance people out and they look at it to see whether or not the site should be moved back from the creek or if there's some kind of issue where garbage could be getting into the creek. But the first thing they do is contact us to see whether or not it's licensed or not even fully licensed, but maybe just paid and don't have that license in hand yet. If you paid, then we consider it in the program.
And then what we do is we say, no, we want to run interference on this site ourselves, and they go, okay.
Let's let
them
catch up.
Do not hold a dog fishing in that. They're fishing in a lot of people that they are, especially those shy short doona. But the doona, they are suspect, they are drinking, they are not Chinese, but not only new John Power, John Watch, they are. Now they are able to do what they are doing. 从中东的街呢,人家呢,那天我那时候来嘛,然后路来时路路地方面呢,他爹那不么一家那里,那要困难呢,也那么了,都有多,比我那么的那天都太多怕,那天都有多,来时你有弄那些债,有我整那些债,要他爹那么了,那天我今天还在那天,半途可能跑上那么了,就被没了,那天,飞行员去多啊。
也那个东西我那来得了，就开着那白皮，那好多钱了，那么好invoice，那些，那好贵呢。就那要我那好去过过来了。对，我那，本地飞行员多嘛，来，我那个嘛，我要第三个，那是一个找了条不一样东西，我那些，我要你好条飞行员的包了呢，要是来送菜的，要么的呀，就用我那些。
Fishing game will come to a site if I have concerns about it, and it's in our licensing program. We recently had somebody over on the other side of the hill, closer to Weaverville, who came in and paid, and I looked at his site on a map, and then I looked on the computer at Google Earth, and I thought, this could be problematic. I went and looked at the site, and it is problematic because he cultivated right next to a creek. So I contacted Fish and Game, and I said, will you come look at this site with me? And they came out and looked at the site, and they said, yeah, he needs to do this, 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 and this. And then he's not going to have a problem with us. So that's the approach that we're trying to take on the worst ones. We're trying to have Fish and Game come out and look at them with us in the field and tell us what somebody needs to do so they won't be in trouble. And other sites that are not in the program that are in that same area, I can't do anything about those. If they're not in our program, I can't do anything. So the neighbor who thinks you are an idiot, if you're in the program, you're going to get a lot more help and you're not going to get in trouble like that neighbor would.
So,
but we're not ratting out the neighbor. I don't rat anybody out.
No. Maybe.
I don't know, we talked about the, or John brought it up regarding, you know, ratting out your neighbor or whatnot. Are these folks aware of what the complaint process is? If they want to do that and that it is confidential, we don't give out information, I think that they should be aware of that.
Okay, let's move forward with what Leslie's.
Leslie, I'm going to finish Leslie first. แล้วมันจองก็จะเริ่มมามุชัวเจมาปอขอดินโอชิยาชิยาชิยาโอเจได้ตรงเรานี่มุเตยายุมตรงได้นะเจละมาลิคอเดแล้วจะมกก็ขอโคโคเรคชั่นนะมันแม่มาก็จะตอวอลินอวอลินอวอลินอมาเฟติจอยใจก็อวอลก็จะเตยนะเนี่ยก็จะอวอลจอนเปซังก็อวอลนะเจก็จะอวอลจะเตยนะเนี่ยเจขอน้อยขอวอ่าแล้วมันจะไปชีอ่า
Did you get it both of wrong? Both of
them? I'm already here wrong, but I'm asking a question like, who is not wanting to be in the program that is
shown up? No, don't tell anybody. Go do what you need.
That is only for if somebody does have a complaint, they should know how that process works. I don't want them to do it now, but.
ก็ตัวน้องก็มันเห็นว่าเทนาจุนะก็มันคงยันนอนสิปุ่นอยู่เทนาคุณยันแล้วเราคุณต้องมาอยากก็อะไรเนี่ยคุณมาสั่งนะอยากก็อะไรเนี่ยยอมคุณไม่จะเนี่ยแบบรุ่นใดอยากก็สาคอมเพลนโตแล้วจอดปุ่นนี้น้องเทเนี่ยบอกเป้าขับพรอเซสเนอร์แล้ววันนี้คอมเพลนโชว์น้องจุ่มไม่ยืนในยุคเป้าเด็กก็เทียบปุ่นนี้เราจะเคลียร์แล้วนะโอเคเวลามีการบุกปุ่นนี้เราจุ่มนะต้องมาแล้ววันนี้จะเริ่มใส่ตาเนาะ
I don't trust the confidential. So, another twist, another item is if you call me, tell me about the problem, I will come out and look, and if I see it, I will report it if you wish me to under my name. So there's no retribution, there's no one hitting you or shooting.
Take a burn.
That's part of the job, yes.
This is just pertaining to Post Mountain.
District 5.
District G's new district G's to call me to Lapisone. Then you have Tilunda pain, Your name is to like a cross, you watch your time, and this Then I have a whole polygon, my change, you know, don't make pedona. Then you don't join the drama, so she will hear you here. She don't tell the yellow way. You are eating name, what I don't know, and I say.
I just have to see it, no hearsay. I have to go see it.
You have to go see it.
Hey, brother, you said you're talking about complaints. Can you talk a little bit more about how you're going to handle enforcement this year as it pertains to licensed growers and unlicensed growers? Especially in Post Mountain.
Let
me translate that.
If you're in the licensing program and and I know that, I'm not even going to look at any of those. I have enough to do without even thinking about. The only time I would is if, for whatever reason, somebody isn't
complying
and they get dropped from the permit process. That would be the only time that I may step in. Is if somebody lost their license for something that they were doing. My main focus is going to be just on anybody outside the guidelines of the state and the county ordinances. So the state says we can have 6 marijuana plants, or you can have a commercial permit to grow. So anybody outside those guidelines, I will be looking at.
Okay, Rob, and you tell you that. In the call, we're not just the DM part here. No, I should say, look to Gino, look up program, no, Hadina. But you're a commercial,
So I just more back to some of what his question was is that, you know, regarding the pines, it really doesn't, to me it doesn't matter where the geographical area is. If there's a complaint, I'm going to go there. And it doesn't necessarily have to be a complaint. It could be something I see also, or one of my officers see. So we're not going to target any specific area. It's just kind of, it's just a day-to-day kind of thing that we do. But I do want to focus on more of the complaints, more than we have in the past, because we've never got through all the complaints in a year. I mean, because there's hundreds of them. Yes.
You guys won't, I mean, the only reason I brought Post Mountain was obviously it's densely populated with growers, and a lot of illegal growers who cause environmental damage. And I was just wondering if there was going to be like time allotted or more focus on that.
Well, the difference between the pines and anywhere else is nobody's really complaining out there.
Yeah.
So I feel like I want to, if somebody's being a bad neighbor and not growing within the guidelines, then I want to direct my attention to that issue.
Okay.
Than in a place where there isn't a complaint. But not to say that I won't go out there.
Yeah.
Or it's just that I want to try and deal with the complaints first. And if I get others along the way, well, that's
true. Come and go.
Yeah.
Okay, Casey.
Go ahead.
你还得找手中不是吗？妈妈在厂子手中了，那个手中上，要得不能complain，就把那个把体呢都做了。再呢，人家打了把来做几道，完了去不能走了，其中了不能，就不能这样。这一年的要了complain，二也要了保呢，还得那我去找这家里人，他们保的也是找了一点。那请假我可不敢弄，老了一毛钱多点。 背景的叫officer的叫我路弄啊，保一老天的老，人做到现在，这些的话我可是老还没有发觉，要对对complain的，我留了一个牌位，你弄的呢。Can I bring an issue real quick? And then we'll go to
the, yeah, over there.
Look at it. Leslie Ron and John.
Yes, what?
I think this is something that, you know, I like to see all the county and chaos and all the stuff going on, you know, like, example, Siskiyou County. I don't know if there's a leadership, lack of leadership over there, or language there, or because of fear or whatever, and there's no network or connections with the Hmong community between law enforcement and the Hmong community over there, and we have a lot of negative image, a lot of negative things going on in Siskiyou County, and many Hmong people that I talk to believe that the sheriff over there targeting the Hmong people specifically. And I don't want to see that in here, but if you can inform everybody the right way that, because I don't see, the illegal is not here.
Why would they be here?
Yeah, they're scared to show their face because they might take pictures and, hey, you're the guy that made bomb in the storm. To eliminate that chaos and that, you know, kind of like profiling thing or assuming that they're being targeted, I think the best way is to break the bear, which is maybe sending them a letter in Hmong saying the law has changed. 6 plants or commercial. That's it. Other than that, you will see, you have a chance of seeing the sheriff or fishing game. I mean, that has to be pretty vivid and clear across the board. And so, if you show up and say, they will say, hey, why are you talking to me or the mom? You know, did you receive the letter in mom? And then, I mean, I just think that that would be a very thoughtful thing to consider.
I think what we don't want is to make it seem like the county is targeting, you know.
We don't want to be like Siskiyou County.
We want them to understand.
I have areas south of the South Fork that I would like Ron to go, and you won't feel targeted at all.
Well,
these are people that are really damaging the whole idea of having cannabis or having a product.
I have two ladies call me. Can I go
say, six plants for commercial.
That's it.
And I said the same thing, and they said, well, if I don't get anything from the county informing, then I will grow.
Then you're just making it up.
But if I see something, then I know they know my parcel. That's why they sent me a direct letter, so I don't grow. I will grow six plants instead of trying to get in trouble.
Again, it's not the county's responsibility to let you know the law. It's your responsibility to know the law. Siskiyou County is its own animal. I'm sorry, I apologize. I know several supervisors up there, they're great people, but it's a different animal. It really is. And so is the sheriff. And I get along with them, but I don't agree with them.
I just want to add one little thing. I've been doing this for, this will be the sixth year, code enforcement. And I've always tried to keep it equal.
Electioneering here.
I can vouch for that.
Yes, she can. And actually, it's usually more in your guys' favor than it isn't. And I try to keep it that way. And at some point, it may reverse,
yes.
I'm afraid.
Yeah.
I mean, if it continues the way it is, I'm afraid it's going to reverse and it's going to look badly because, you know, we're getting sightings, all these others, and they're moved on or whatever. But, if, you know, if I keep it the same path I've been working on, I think that it's going to reverse where the Hmong community is going to be sighted more than the other. But because I'm trying to be safe at what I do, not to focus on any one particular group.
So you're being politically correct.
Yes.
Terrific. But there's areas south of the South Fork that you can just go and...
I know.
Leave those mountains.
Oh, I wrote it. No, I'm kidding. So basically, Ron, you know,
if you have good backup and the CAO can make the decision for county council instead of having five people that don't really know what they're, a lot of things, they don't really know, we don't really know what we're talking about, whereas legal counsel, I'm serious, I mean, come on, whereas Leslie knows more about it, CAO knows more about it, legal counsel can focus in on them and make some binding decisions. They're supposed to let us know which direction. The issue of
stacking.
The idea of future stacking. Last year he paid $6,000. A couple days ago he paid another $6,000, and he urged for that stacking incentives, and he wants demand you to put the agenda.
And he will show up.
It, but is it a personal item specifically to you?
He's stating that on behalf of everyone who had the same concern and issue.
And the issue has not been resolved because?
It's not available at this time.
It's not been discussed at all.
And how will staff be resolving this issue?
You would need to...
No. I'm asking you, how do you plan on resolving this issue? How do you plan on presenting it to the Planning Commission if it moves that way? How do you plan on presenting it possibly to Rick Tippett if not he's involved in it? And I agree with that. The next step up is CAO and County Council and then the Board of Supervisors. If you are not satisfied with what's going on, Leslie's, after you pass through these people, Leslie's the one who has the responsibility. Then CAO or Tippett. It's a little confusing there, I'm still confused. Then CAO, and then the board would take a look at it. This is the process.
Yeah.
So it would have
so to I know I'm dumping back on you, but this is the process.
So the argument that I would make for that is that we have 500 and a few more available. If those still are available and people are not coming in to get them, then it makes sense to go back and offer people a shot at it that are already in the program to take the remaining licenses.
Okay, I have a head shaking over here. What's
I'm
that?
I'm in complete agreement with Leslie.
Yeah.
Can you restate it or state it in a differently or better? Not that it's bad.
No, I would defer to Leslie.
Okay.
I think she explained it very well.
I could make other arguments in addition to that, but that is the basis of the argument would be we want to flesh out all of these licenses. Since we're not getting the participation from outside, we would like to be able to backfill it from people that are inside since they already know how the system works.
You do not want to have five supervisors with very little information try and solve your problem. You want Leslie to solve your problem first, and if she can't do it, then it moves up the chain. And you have a focus of what the problem is to present to five people who do an adequate job.
So would that require staff to change the ordinance or add language to it?
I have no idea that...
Yeah, there would have to be an amendment to the ordinance because right now it's one association per person in the county, whether...
The reason there is so, adamant about this $6,000 that they pay, that they want incentive, it's almost relevant to what the Board of Board is doing to us too. Example for me, I don't know if you remember Lieutenant Little and then Cat.
Yes.
They checked on my water board and I told him about July 21st, 2016, prior to the urgency ordinance. I voluntarily paid for it because I knew that that's going to come. And I did that and I told them and they said, well, you're grandfathering in. So you are 50 feet away from any creek. And Cat was like 5 years and Lieutenant confirmed that it's permanent. That's what they told me vividly.
Right.
So that's what he's saying. Can we get some kind of incentives like that with the county? For those of us who are early birds, voluntarily come out of the woods and doing this, give the county money and do the right thing and secure the spot, but we want to live in on that and see how the county responds to that.
It's worth a discussion and to propose what it is you have in mind. Off the top of my head, I don't know what you would be looking at, but if you make your case and then let me see if that's a defendable thing.
Do you think we should gather all those people and then make a case and meet with you?
Sure.
That would be like some
and it would be great if it's okay to translate a little bit of what she said about potentially being able to stop Okay, so the high economy had the logical,
Another very common thing that people have been asking for is to have your payment be due the on the anniversary of when you pay for it. So if somebody doesn't buy a 2018-19 license until May 15th, they want it to last until the following May 15th. That's one example of a change that people would like to see. You're talking more about incentives. Go ahead and propose some.
I translated your incentive idea, sort of, and if they want it, they have to ask for it. I agree with that, too. Yeah.
But put it in paper and set up a meeting, and she will coordinate with CAO and county council.
Okay, let's do that. He followed, he understand being compliant with the state and the county. And he ordered the county ordinance. He came here, he bought his place for over $400,000 just so that he can grow. He has the legit facilities to be in compliance with the ordinance. Just the home. And then he, you know, went through the garden, the thing, you know, inspections and all that. He paid his due, $6,000 each year for the last 2 years. And then, $700 for engineering for his farm. Just to meet the code. $7,000 for engineering, excluding the repair or the, you know, the construction or whatever. Just to meet the code with fishing game. And all he wants is fairness. Because he knows that people are illegally wrong and they don't give a damn about the ordinance. And they don't respect your ordinance, who you vote for.
He just wants to be fair,
that's all. He doesn't demand anything else. All he wants is fairness.
Mm-hmm. Where does he live? What section?
211 or Pokeba.
Douglas City,
okay. Thank you.
Some of the confusion might be coming from, that's really related to not getting out of the
terminal,
right? Yeah. Because some people, when they came in and paid, especially because a lot of the stuff getting issued or invoices were being issued really close to the deadline.
Right.
And so people were given the option to pay for 2017, 2018, or 2018, 2019.
Yeah, okay.
And or, I guess. You could pay for both. But I think a lot of people, because of the language barrier, didn't understand that it wouldn't really affect their license spot. So I think if there's probably in their case, if there's a way to, for someone who paid, say, in March, to come back in and say, look, I meant to pay that for 2018, 2019. I think that's a simple fix for people. And, you know, really the value that they wanted was a license during that time. And because everyone was behind and it took a long time to issue, it would be nice. I know I have quite a few people who were like, hey, I would like that 12 grand I put up, really to just be 6 grand for 18, 19 and get their $6,000 back. Or have a credit for 19, 20.
I recently asked about that, and that was not, I made no headway with that whatsoever.
Who did you ask?
Yeah.
I have 3 loyal, kind of like the followers behind. They didn't pay their share in 16, 17, 18. And they came to me and said, what do I do next? I'm going to pay for my spot. And we went to the county and we asked that, well, these are, you know, they want to pay, should they pay for 17 or 18? And then double pay, you know? And we heard the voices that it's up to them, you know, what they want to pay for. They can pay for 17, 18 in a month, come back and pay for 18 and 19. And so they got a little bit smarter now. You know, once they understand that, they're like, why would I pay for 6, 17, and 18? I mean, I'm not an idiot. Now, I understand, you know, what that means. So I was going to pay for 18 and 19. And they went on a month later, they come back and pay for 18 and 19.
A lot of people
and I feel like I've been taking advantage of that too because I paid 17 and 18.
Well, so before I was given direction not to do it, I gave people a very good choice. And then after a certain point, a foot was put down and I was not allowed to give people choice and they either had to come in. And you guys have to educate yourselves on the ordinance and when the dates go to. Because once our office is told, this is the direction, raise it, go, that's it. So you guys have to be aware of deadlines, dates. You guys need to communicate within your own community and be aware of those things.
I think they're aware, but it was very, very convoluted and confusing. And I know personally, because I've dealt with it a lot, and I was even confused on the issue of, hey, if they don't do this, are they going to have to completely reapply and then wait another 6 months to get even something issued? So I was telling people, hey.
And some of those who paid for 17 and 18, they told me they regretted that they paid. They should have waited a little bit longer and then come and pay for 18 and 19, and they would save $6,000, and that's why they are complaining about that.
Sure, and that's why I'm going to be that much more in favor of
I got laughed at it too myself. Because I talk to a few people and they say, why are you so stupid? You know, why are you doing that? You know, because I get the same thing that you're getting now. So that's why they ask me for incentives. And who's going to get the last laugh, you know? Like
that makes sense. I can understand why.
Does that make sense?
Totally.
Well, I will say this. You know, last year everyone grew. You weren't supposed to grow. You didn't have your license.
Oops.
If you got through, thank your lucky stars you got through. Because it's not fun when you don't get through that year. And you get cut because you didn't have all the proper paperwork. And so I look at the fees we paid last year as a pass. And now we're renewing, we're paying for the new year. They did the work, they're going to continue doing it, so we're paying them to do that work. And we're going on to a new year. You know, if you really don't have the money, like, you have to just communicate, and I'm sure, I don't know if there is, I can't speak for them, but we can, you can't, you don't know until you ask, you know. And so, for me, I paid last year, and I'm going to pay again this year. Whether if it's 30 days together or not, I'll figure it out. If I don't have it, I will talk to them and say, I really don't have it. I have to work something else.
Okay, who are you going to talk to?
Leslie.
Exactly. If you go to a Board of Supervisor meeting and you listen to what's going on, that's terrific. Thank you for coming and thank you for being there. If you don't understand something or something isn't clear, talk to Leslie. Don't talk to me because I probably won't answer you or I'll tell you I don't know. Also, think about that when you talk to other supervisors that are up there. We like to think we know everything. We don't. An example is last board meeting. Supervisor Moore started saying something, and I see Leslie out there with staff, and staff is going like this. And I'm sitting there going, God, just don't. Don't.
Stop.
just board, don't see it, because I don't want to bring it up, but he's right. He's absolutely correct that this is these are the people that know what's going on.
Yeah, don't just come to me. You can code it anybody here, my staff, and we should all have the same answer to something.
Who would you be going to about that issue of getting essentially a refund? Like, if they ask you, then who do you have to ask in order to try and get that refund?
I suggest you contact the CAO about that.
You talking about $6,000?
Yeah.
I suggest you do, because that's not the way that it's been set up. And there's been reluctance to let go of the idea that all along when you bought, you were buying a number. Not necessarily that license. Yes, we want to issue the license, but it was to secure a slot. That's been the whole purpose of it.
Yeah, but then it came up, now there's still spaces, so that,
right.
That's why they're not.
And that's why now you go, what's the value? There are still spaces, so.
And let Dr. Coons, let CAO start to work his magic in getting this straightened out. Instead of having five people sticking their fingers in everything.
I think we have a question over there.
Yeah, somebody have a question, might get up to think, but that's the more it.
Yeah. จงมีเป้จงมีอยู่เป้ต่อแต่จงมีอะไรยังกะหลายสิ่งต่อไปเลยแล้วสิเขาจงมีเป้จิตต่อเป้จิตต่อต่อมันเป้ต่อเชี่ยนมาวีเดียแล้วจุดต่อวีดีเป้เขาใส่วันนี้จะสอนวีดีเป้เขาใส่เนอะอย่าหาชิมเมียนเดียวเลยแล้วเขาว่าจิปูเป้ให้เราอย่าชิมเราอะไรจุดไม่ใช่ก็ได้ว่าจิปูเป้ให้เราอย่าชิมเราอะไรจุดไม่ใช่ก็ได้ว่า ที่ทำแล้วเขาตัวก้อนที่ทำแล้วเขาตัวข้างม้วนอะไรเช่นนั้นอยู่เลยจีม้วนอะไรที่สานี่เนี่ยแต่ชิโน่เป้มเทลมาอย่างถ้าชิโน่จิตตัวตัวเต้ถ้าชิเป้ตัวอย่างนั้นก็จะเต้เจ้าอะไรอย่างถ้าชิโน่ตัวจิตตัวตัวก้อนนี้วันนี้เป้คอนติเนียลเจ้าอะไรอย่างเป้ต่อแล้วตัวก้อนจ้ะอีกคนอะไรอย่างเขาอ้อตัวอย่างแล้วตัวก้อนเลยอ้อนอกจากเจ้าจีเท่านั้นเลยเลยก่อนอยู่ข้อเราเลยเจ้าเจ้าตัวถี่ก็หอยเนี่ยจะเป็นจีม้วนอะไรเช่น
เนี่ยลิฟูเจแล้วหมดกับหมดกับถ่ายไปเลยจะพูดถูกต้องมันเดียตัวอินเจเนียร์เราหมู่พอเปล่าเทคของเนี่ยก่อนหมดสีมันเนี่ยหมดเนี่ยนะเนี่ยจะได้เอาไปสร้างของเนี่ยนะจะหมดว่าก็ต้องสอบว่าจะเลยถูกก็ก็แล้วพอทำไมเราก็คอนดิชันอลไลเซนส์นั่นแหละเราดูคอนดิชันอลมาหมดแต่ลักษณะตอนได้แต่ฉันก็จะต้องว่าน้องว่าน้องน้องนะจะหมดเชื่อก็ว่าเนี่ยจีอาร์เดียที่หมดก็
I've been here for a month, and I've done a few inspections. I see a few familiar faces in here. You guys can speak amongst each other, and if you guys want to get a hold of us, too, to let us know when you're ready for a site visit, that's also something you can do.
Anytime.
I will leave my card here before I leave, and if there's anyone here that wants to set up a site visit, I am more than...
And Jeff, I don't think they understand that. You know, the people that follow me, I always tell you to come inspect the site. And you did it, right?
Right. Always.
Yeah, so. นี่เราต้องยืนหลีกต้องมาซื้อถึงมุมเราเอาไปขัดเชิญแต่ชิมานุนานะย้อนนี่ยอมมากให้ตัวสู้กลัวนะไอ้นี่ต้องตรงนี้จะเตะสมมติชอบเจอตู้ขอพรสิ่งอะไรอย่างนั้นแต่เนี่ยเราไม่เบสิสก็ตอนนั้นแต่เนี่ยหูเราแต่ตัวเราเนี่ยจีเขาต้องยืนเลยจะคิดว่าเนี่ยนะ
กูมาไม่จอเนี่ยกูซื้อเดียวเจ้ากูบอกว่าเจ้าเป็นเจ้าที่ว่าเนี่ยว่าไอ้กูชิปปอลที่ไอ้กูอยากเนี่ยก็ตัวกูตัวนั้นแหละเจ้าตัวกูตัวนั้นแหละเจ้าเสกเจ้าเก็บอยู่ถึงตัวเดียวแล้วเดี๋ยวขณะยังเขาบอกกับเจ้าก็ไปส่งเชื่อแล้วไปว่าเนี่ยจะไปที่ชอชิโอแล้วแต่ขอเลยแล้วตัวกูตาเจ้าเลยมาเรียกเคลียร์อยู่แต่ยังไม่ขอเขาเรียกตัวเจ้าเลยมาเรียกโม่ได้ไลเซนส์เราอยู่เดียวไปโม่ก็ได้ชิปก็ดีขอได้เนาะอยากไป
I know I sent the list over to you guys about the people we have. I'll go through that and see and talk to them and see who hasn't had their site inspection, and then let you guys know and follow up, and then we'll have them sign that agent authorization form too, so that if there's any communication, you guys can call us directly, because we have like 4 or 5 people that can go out there if you guys need it or translate the stuff.
Okay. One question. Okay. Taking Jata, this is no. เราลงนํามาในฟอร์สตาร์ไปเนี่ยบริษัทได้ก็ได้นํากันมาแล้วที่คอมพลีทเดต้าหมดทั้งนี้ทั้งนี้เพื่อเกี่ยวกับเดต้านะที่ชีวิตเราก็แล้วก็เอาแบรนด์เนี่ยก็เอาแบรนด์สตาร์มาเจอมาหมดแบบเดชของไอซ์แล้วก็ที่ชีวิตมีกูจะกูจะได้เราไปแล้วคือจะเปลี่ยนนะรู้ว่าเออแต่แบรนด์ดันเราแล้วมันจะให้เราเปลี่ยนโอเคแต่ฉันเราจะไม่เกี่ยวกับน้องเรามาเราจะไปติดต่อกันนะไปติดเอาหมดจบเราถึงไหนที่จะเป็นชัวร์ที่เราเล่าเองเลยอ่ะ
Staff, you're in charge of the administration and the bands.
Yep.
And, that, and they, him and his brother all went to the county to pay for their rules and everything, application, all that, with the exception that they have not heard anything about the variance, you know, and somebody in the county told him that it's going to be 3 months out because of, you know, the load that they carried. The question is, should he go ahead and go without a problem, because it can be an issue for him. He doesn't want it to... A cloud is hanging on his head, but to be clear,
you need to have the variance approved before you start growing. Over the last week, I've read through every single variance application that's been submitted over the last year and a half, and I created a framework, a checklist, so that we can create a more predictable process for the variances. On Monday, I'm going to start doing inspections for variances, and we're going to see how fast we can make things move.
And they understand that. If they're going to stretch 3 months in order for them to hear the events, that's going to be sometime in July. And that's already past growing season. You know,
well, if it's up to me, it's going to happen faster than that, but I can't make any guarantees.
Can they personally come in contact with you and
sure.
Get their thing first?
Sure. Well, again, on Monday, I'm going to start contacting, in order that we've received them, variances. I'm going to start doing inspections. I'm going to start writing staff reports and have things go as fast as we can.
If somebody didn't get their variance approved and they went ahead and submitted for a state license, if it comes back to you, you would deny that.
Yes. Okay. Along with the variances, with the variances that are being moved forward, it only has to be heard by the Planning Commission. And Leslie can always say that she would like to have a special Planning Commission meeting.
As we have 2 per month right now.
As the variances come in, and to help move them forward a little faster, and request some additional revenue from general fund to finance the hearings or the Planning Commission meeting.
We've only had 1 person working on them so far, and now she's still working on some, and now Scott is going to work on some. So it should make, we're hoping to speed up that process.
Now that we have a checklist, things should go a lot faster.
Yeah. One concern I have for the parents application is that lessons got. I speak English okay, you know, I'm okay. I don't have issue, but I know there's so many people have. And I have a problem with the variance application myself. You know, I just like, what is that? You know, I don't understand it, and it's giving me a very hard time comprehending.
The application itself.
Oh, yeah, comprehending that and go through that and complete it. And I know that if I have a problem, I mean, think about all these people here. They're going to run into the same issue.
Do you need to do a variance workshop?
Well,
yeah, let's do that.
Or it could be just as easy as if you come into the office and there's components that you're unclear about, we can help you through
that.
If you make an appointment before you come in, we can set time aside
that
to actually help you.
That
just send me an email. We'll set up a time.
Yeah. I'll explain that because I got the same thing. I have an issue with the parents' application. I went in there and they helped me. And we got clear through it and I feel good about it. I can make coffee. I can help all these people doing the same thing. To repeat, you know, replicate that, you know.
What section of the county do you live in?
Definitely.
Which one?
Definitely.
Okay. Also, if it slows down too much, this is an item where you would come before the board in public comment and say the variances are taking too long.
Yeah.
We really need to work on it. Would you please assist Leslie in moving this forward?
When does that mean?
You can go
to any board meeting and ask.
But are the variances taking too long? Let's see how this works for the next couple of weeks. If you're satisfied, if you're not, then the next step would be to move it up to CAO. If you want to sidestep CAO Coons, then you can come before the board and say, you need to do something about your variances. Trust me, there's three or four or five people that come in that aren't you, that come in every couple of weeks and, you know, say the same thing regarding cannabis over and over. I wasn't referring to you. I'm terribly sorry if you took it personally.
Let me
I was referring to cannabis.
Good question. How do we know that we have to have variance? I mean,
so basically, you're going to need a variance if you're 350 feet, if you're within 350 feet of any
structure.
Well, neighbors,
it has to be a permitted dwelling.
Some.
You know, here's a rumor
that you just started.
All right, hold on. Right. Right.
Io ho detto un meglio, un buon umbigo, questo dentro, adesso ci mangio tre faccia assate, ne? Vediamo. Vai. Tu ne vuoi luce, io
ci mangio.
Ma ci vuole essere
male. Vuole essere male, già stato, no? Ma io non vuole.
Già. Io ho
detto
che non vuole essere male. Già. He said that if he, his farm is next year, another five, who has a legal dwelling within 350 feet wall, and he's a grower too, will he still be happy to the variance?
Yes, it has to be the variance, but it helps his case when he applies for the variance if the neighbor doesn't have a problem with the activity that he's conducting being cultivating cannabis.
Which would be produced in a letter.
Which would be the adjoining property owner.
Supporting letter.
Yeah.
Or during public comment at a planning.
Okay.
给做软件费嘛，你到软件了，原来怎么去的？你OK吧？OK。OK。我们那块没得吧？呀，你啊，就是那，你之前用的这，比如讲那样，那什么被盗啊，来到inspection单了，那些，那收了几多多，拆破的，被盗啊，搞，搞啥子玩意儿？收了玩意儿，那给，哎，要多了多几趟，那么那，别都交不得了嘛，都过老了，我讲。
Yeah.
What was that? That's Jeff. Okay, that's to Jeff. Yeah. He said that
ไปจองไปจองไปส่งได้ไปจองได้แล้วมันตุกตาป้าก็ต้องเลยจวนแล้วตุกอันได้ไปมาจองไปมาจองไปยังป้าย่าตุกตาป้าก็ยังก็ยังจองได้นะก็จะต้องมองก็เฟ้นจองอยู่หรอก็จะต้องมองอย่าสนใจกว่าคุยยังไงจะได้แต่ยาวเลยจะต้องตุกนะยังจะต้องบอกจะเจ้าหน้าที่อยู่จองอยู่ฟังกันนะจะสนใจเออคุยกับเฟ้นต่อไปต่อไปต่อไปต้องกว่าอีจองก็
จะเอาจอยมาเนี่ยก็อยู่ข้างแฟนจะขออย่าอยู่อันใดอยู่ที่อันใดที่นี่นะขอให้แค่ไม่ดีนะมาขอจอยมาเราจะต้องก็ท่าเดี๋ยวตัวอ่ะเราต้องเขียนในไอเดียต้องมีจานนะเนาะมันจะโอเคต้องก็ต้องอาจจะเจนได้ไหมโอเคนี่จะต้องมั่วจะต้องบอกกันเนาะมาในไทยมาในนอกเลยแต่ก็เลือกที่อันใดก็เลือกอยู่ด้วยเลยยังจูดใจก็ใช้ก็ได้มั่วอ่ะไอเดียไม่ใช่พวกมัน
So basically,
we're kind of relying on you people as farmers. You know that when you put in a box or a grow pot or a, you know, however your particular method of growing is, you can determine, you pretty much know if I have a 4 foot box, 5 foot box, a 200-gallon grow bag, you know pretty much how big your plant's going to get. So when you think about it that way, you can look at the square footage of a box. You know how much over that box that plant's going to grow, or you have a pretty good idea. We're not going to go out and say, you know, you're that much over on each one of your plants, and you've got to cut those off. You know,
you're not.
What we're going to do is we're going to do your best with the cultivation area you have to end up at maturity with 10,000, not over 10,000 square feet of mature canopy. If you have been very reasonable, and you're, you know, slightly over, it is what it is. But if you have taken that and taken advantage of that 200% of your cultivation area that we are allowing you to have, and it's very obvious that you've taken advantage of it, then we're going to call you on it. And that's going to be a violation that you have to correct up on.
And to add to that, so I don't, like, maybe you could ask how many people are planning to do two houses or three houses?
Houses.
Okay, so with the hoop house, the way we're going to look at it is if we open the door of the hoop house, if we look inside that door and all the plants are touching together, whatever the square footage is of that hoop house or greenhouse, that's what we're going to decide is your canopy, mature canopy.
At that point, do we call that cultivation area or do we call that square footage of your canopy?
Yeah.
So if you plug a hoop house, that we, because right now your cultivation area is defined by either a fenced area for your, you could have 20,000 square feet of fenced area, or you could actually have 20,000 square feet of hoop house. That's all considered cultivation area.
Okay. As long
but
as
you just
decide,
can't,
you don't go.
You can't.
Yeah.
You can't. Yeah. You can't exceed the 10,000 square feet of mature canopy when it's all said and done.
Okay.
Are you measuring boxes and, say, beds and hoop houses besides the canopy?
Well, what we're looking at is a hoop house is a cultivation area. The cultivation area is either determined by a fenced-in area for outdoor or the square footage of your hoop house or greenhouse. That's the cultivation area. So your canopy, however your whatever your method is, can exceed 10,000 square feet. So we're assuming inside of a hoop house that you can have aisleways, walkways, area, you know, between plants to get sunlight, and you're not going to actually be using that whole square footage as a canopy. It's that way it's considered cultivation area and not canopy.
So your canopy would be your beds.
It would be your beds, and then if you're 2 feet over each bed, then your square footage is increased from the bed side to the box side.
What about foxes? Because I know Victor had a question about foxes. We're going to have some translation. I think she'll translate. He had a question about foxes because I think they were measured 6x6. But he actually had a comment about foxes.
Okay. So just do the math. Do the math. You know, if you want to end up with 10,000, take 10,000 square feet, divide it by, if you have a 5x5 box, and let's say your plants are going to grow a foot over that box or 2 feet over, whatever you think, just do the math.
So you'll take their discretion on how kind of how big their plants
are. Yeah, we had determined at one time that if you were to take a 4-foot box, and you were to take the 4-foot box and your plant went over the edges of the box by a foot, I believe, on all sides.
2 feet. So if it's an 8-foot plant, that's going to be 50 square feet.
Okay. Divide that by 10,000. That's how many boxes that you should try it out. That's
and for Victor, I understand that not every strain is going to be the same.
Right.
You're going to have some that can be very wide.
But you as farmers know what you're doing. This is your business. So you can pretty much realistically determine how big your plants are going to get with the method of growing, whether it be a pot, a box, or a bed.
So basically, we're
working on a handout. We ran it by the state yesterday, the state how cannabis, and they said, you guys are on the right track. So we're working on a handout to make it more predictable. That should be out soon.
Showing different methods, bags, boxes, beds, and how to kind of determine how many of each.
Cultivation area, they saw go cheap pass for feet, all right? That she does not learn more, when they saw, actually, then go pass for feet, right? Then go now. They could do propagation like babies.
Yeah, you can do your vegging or your immature plants aren't counted as canopy.
Okay. So
but they have to be done inside that 20,000 square feet.
Okay.
I got a question. So I understand the hoop houses, you can't run power to it, right?
No.
But see, now we can't have clones because it's a whole period plant, right? So it's going to bloom without light.
If you have a greenhouse, you can have light. You can actually do your clones inside of a permitted building with power. And under lights, and that's allowable.
The big thing with the hoop house is it's not a permanent structure.
Yeah.
So it falls under its own guidelines as to what you can and can't do in there. But the greenhouses, that's a permanent structure. There's a lot more that you can do with that.
I'm just, like, for me, I'm in the Pines too.
Yeah.
So we don't have power.
Yeah.
And,
can you mention a little bit about how the lighting might have to be down?
Yeah, you can't, your light, if you have, let's say you have a permanent greenhouse and you have power, just for example.
Or you generate it.
Yeah. We do have a noise ordinance.
That'll be coming after he explains the...
And the light isn't supposed to just go outside of your property. And there's reasons for that. Fish and Game looks at it, it can disturb wildlife. It can disturb a neighbor who's trying to sleep and the light's coming in their window. We've got plenty of complaints like that. So basically, be considerate. We don't need those UFOs out there.
And also, what's the requirement of the generator? There's a certain hour.
It's
10 o'clock.
11. Like, is it 10 to 8 a.m.? 6 to 10.
10 o'clock.
10 p.m. to 8 or 7.
If you're running a generator, you should also be in containment. So if you leak fuel, there's a bunch of
them. Yeah. So are you aware of that?
Oh, that might.
Yeah, they were just asking about the greenhouse, the hoop house, if there's a permit. I said, yeah, it's 300.
It's just 300, yeah. It could be up to 30 by 100.
34 by 34.
30, so
$350.
34. I'm like 300
by 100. Yeah, how I am. Yeah, the green apply for greenhouse, we don't know for and the power, change one will include the whole power and the power for the past quarter.
So,
you
mentioned that one. Okay. So, the power that it's just a greenhouse,
huh? We will have a greenhouse.
So, his question is basically his license for greenhouse and outdoor.
License type.
2B. Okay. 2B is for outdoor, but you can have lights on vegetative plants. As soon as they're flowering over, I believe it's half inch distal, you have to move them outside, no more lights. If you have a type 2B, that mixed light license, you can have them under light as mature plants. We don't have an indoor license. And that is 25 watts per square foot, so really large amount of light. Mm-hmm. So it's not something that's possible on our electric grid.
So I have to check what license type
okay,
is.
So these are the people you really need to talk to now. Don't talk to me or
come on.
Oh, you can tell, say hello and all. These people know what they're doing. They've been training finally. No, that's fine with me. I've got my phone number. It is my phone number.
And all of the hoop house guidelines are on our website. So.
By the way, that's 180 day permit.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to kind of look at it physically?
We look at it physically when you put it in, and we look at it physically when 180 days is up.
So when they do the site visit, from that day, they have 180 days, and then they come out and visit it again.
ตอนนี้ว่าตาแต่ผมมีแค่นี้อ้วนนี่แหละแล้วตัวชัวร์แต่ชิดเอาเลยถ้าแค่นี้ตอนนี้มันเทคดาวน์ตาลงจงตาลงใจแล้วถ้าตัวชัวร์นะเดี๋ยวลงนะคุณสาเหตุที่โผล่ยุคนี้เดี๋ยวตาเตี้ยหรือช่วงจริงจะกันพวกเข็มลงเทสซี่เนาะเพราะฉะนั้นผมว่าใช่ไหมคุณสาเหตุที่
His question is basically, it's specific to the clients. If they have like a motorhome or an RV, trailer, is there a permitting process requirement?
Yeah, so basically, if you're living in an RV, a motorhome, a trailer, whatever it might be, you need a director's use permit. A director's use permit allows you, it's a seasonal permit. It was designed for people who came here seasonally, had a vacation property in particular, and it was allowed them to recreate on the property. Okay, so now the deal is to get a director's use permit, which you need to install a septic system, number one. Number two, if you're getting licensed, you got to have a dwelling anyhow. So it also allows you, it runs concurrently with your building permit to build your legal house, and you can actually stay in the RV for the length of time that it takes you to build your house and come to completion. So it's no longer, at that point, it's no longer a 90-day seasonal permit. It runs concurrently with your building permit. And septics and the building permit are something that are going to be required anyhow. So.
So.
How many metal containers can they have in their sites?
You can have, they all have to be permitted.
Yeah.
They require 6 feet apart, and it's over an acre, 30 feet from the property line. Mm-hmm. You can have as many as you want. They are for storage only.
Yeah.
But there's actually no limit on the number.
Engineering?
They have to have engineering and a permit. And the reason they have to have engineering is because there's nothing in the building code that tells you how storage containers
are. Come on, let's get started from the engineer.
That's when you're going to know what to tell them.
That's right.
You know, exactly. This is so formal and general that we
come see us, email us.
Yeah, and so we have some food refreshments for you guys.
Hold on, one more thing. We have refreshment here. Don't go home yet. Okay, make some more dinner, get the moment. Can you go to Korea and make some food? Yeah, I'll see you in the day.
Yes.